Sometimes in Airtable, you have two different tables that are linked, and you need to look up specific information from one table into the other. That's pretty standard and simple to do with a lookup, but sometimes it gets more advanced. For those advanced use cases, you need to think outside the box and be sure that you can bring back very specific information, like something that is maybe the oldest, or the most in the future, or the biggest number on an order list. There's a number of different conditions that you can consider, and that's exactly what we're going to be talking about in this video. So if that's of interest, stick around and let's get into it. Welcome back to the channel. If you're new here, my name is Gareth and I am the owner here at Gap Consulting. We've made it our mission to help you get organized and automated with no-code tools. Of course, Airtable is one of our favorite no-code tools. And in this video, I'm going to be showing you how to do those more complicated lookup scenarios. It's a lot more complicated than you might think, but hopefully, after we've gone through this step by step, by the end of this video, you will be a pro and you will totally understand exactly how to get the results you need from your lookup field. But before we get into it, I first want to invite you to join me for my free Airtable crash course. If you're new to Airtable, or if you're a seasoned veteran, but you want to make sure that you stay up to date on the latest and greatest with Airtable, my crash course is going to walk you through the key building blocks of Airtable step by step over a series of days. Grab that crash course at garethpronovost.com/airtable-crash-course. You'll find links below wherever you found this video. But without further ado, let's go ahead and hop right on into it, and we're gonna describe a very simple structure that we have here, but a somewhat complicated problem, at least slightly difficult if you have never built this before. So here we go. On my first table, I have projects. This is simple. This is simple and easy. I've just got three different projects here, and these projects link to tasks, as you see. Now, flipping on over into tasks, and of course this could be built by a template, but maybe every time we do a project, we have the same things that we have to go through. We have to package, then we have to ship, and then we have to confirm the shipment via email or something along those lines. So you see that these are linked to the project, and I've got an order here, so this is the step or the stage in the process. So of course, packaging is first, then shipping, then confirming. And I've also got some dates here, right? So the dates may or may not follow in the same order. So it's important to note that maybe I have a date for shipping that is like, I don't know, the 12th, but for some reason we confirmed this was shipped on the 30th, which of course makes no sense, but it's important to note that things don't always happen linearly, or maybe sometimes they don't. Now we also have the completion here. We can see when we completed a task. And so this is just a simple Boolean value, either yes or no, checked or unchecked. So let's imagine a scenario now where we need to look up what stage, what task has been completed. So we only want to know what task is completed on the project level. So imagine if, just looking at the tasks here, we were to pick on project one. And we can also, of course, we've grouped by project, but we've also been able to sort now by the numbers, which we're already in that order, but let's just add that redundancy. So here I am, my first thing is up at the top, my first task, and then I go in order from here, and I don't care so much about the dates, and I'm also looking at that completed checkbox. So for example, in this scenario, maybe what I want to know is, what is the name of the task for each project that we have completed, but I only want to know the highest number order. So in layman's terms, what I'm trying to say is, here we have project one. We've completed two different things from this particular project. I wanna know which of these is the furthest along in the process. I wanna know which one has the highest order. So in project one's use case or example, I would wanna return the value for ship. I'd wanna know this. Or maybe I wanna know here in project two, again, which one's completed? Well, only one task. So this is the one I need back there, project. And in this case, nothing is completed, so we wouldn't want any information to be flowing back to us. So how do we look this up? How can we build a lookup field that does that? Well, we can go back to the projects table and get started. First thing we're gonna do is create our field. And in our example, I'll call it most recent task completed. And I don't like using the word recent because I don't care about date, I care about the order. So maybe I should rename this like highest order, task completed, or something like that. In either case, Moving on, I'm going to create my lookup field. Now, what am I looking up? Well, I'm looking up tasks that are related to each project. And I would choose a field and I can look up the name, I can look up the project itself, I can look up the order, the date, or the completed checkbox. Let's go ahead and look up the name of the task. But here underneath, I have the opportunity now to conditionally bring in certain information. So I can include only those linked records from the tasks table that meet conditions if I toggle this on. Now, when I do that, I can set my conditions. So what's my first condition? Well, that's easy. It has to be completed. Completed is checked. But what's my second one? My second one is I have a condition where the order is the biggest order of all the orders that meet the first condition. I've already broken this system. Why? Because I can't actually bring in that order number right here. I can't say I only want to bring back the order number that is highest. If I say order is greater than or is empty, I have no way to filter this dynamically and to say of all of the things that are checked, I only want to bring back the order number here. So unfortunately, I'm already at a position here where this is broken and I have to think outside the box. So a lookup field is not going to cut it for us. Let's go ahead and ditch this entirely. And instead, we're going to try a rollup field. Now, a rollup field is the same as a lookup, except that we have the ability to aggregate some of the data using a function or formula. So for this, again, I'll say max order completed. And I will use the rollup field type now. And again, I'm looking at tasks. And again, I want to look up the field. I want to bring in this case, the order number that is the biggest. So I can use a max function. Let's go ahead and max, max parentheses values, as you see here. But I can also apply the condition now. So here's where I can say, I want to bring back the highest number order. I want to bring back that number from the order field, but I only want to do it where completed is checked. So now I'm able to tell it, I don't want to consider anywhere where completed is not yet complete. If it's incomplete, disregard, but I want to know the biggest order. Now, if you remember our order, when we save that field, it's our second task for project one. It's our first task in project two, and it's no task in project three. So we're part of the way there, but we're not 100% complete yet. Now I need to go a little bit further. I need to go back to my tasks table, and I want to bring back this max order completed. Now, this time I will use a lookup field. I'm going to use a lookup from my projects table, and I want to look up that new field that we just created. I don't want to apply any conditions here. Let's just create this field and see what we see. Now, if you recall, for us, we brought back for project one, order number two. For project two, order number one. For project three, order number zero. So now I can build a formula that says, in the case where this order number within the project is the same as the value we looked up, now I want to provide the task name, for example. So I will have this called task name to be shared. And I will create a simple formula here. And the formula couldn't be any easier. If, what are my conditions? Well, my order field, that one right here, must be equivalent to my max order completed field. So if those two things are equivalent and it only occurs one time per project, if that is the case where those things are equivalent, two is two, then I want to bring back the name of this task. So I will say comma name. Again, breaking that down step by step, only if this condition is met, the order is equal to the order max order completed that we created, then I want to know the name of this task. Let's create the field and look at our results. So here we are. The max order completed here, we've got two things completed, but only one and two can be considered here. This number is bigger. That's the formula that we built, or the rollup field, on the previous table. We then looked that up here. Then we wrote a formula that compares this value here to these values, and it's only identical in one case, in this case right here. So we know that this task name to be shared is ship. Here, I've got one thing checked, right? One thing checked. So one is the thing that came back. That's the biggest of the order numbers. Only equal in one case. So I'm only getting text in one record within that grouping. All right, so now we're almost done. I now need to take this value here and look it up on my projects table. So here I am in projects and I can say, whatever this is, current task completed perhaps. And I will use a lookup now. And this time I don't have to set any conditions because I only have one value. And as a matter of logic, I will only ever have one value. So I can now look up the task name to be shared. That's the formula that we just built. I don't have to worry about conditions at all here. I'm going to create the field. And now I can see that the current task that's been completed is shipping. Current task completed here is package. Let's see how we can take this a level further and just make sure that it's working on all sides. As boxes get checked, the rollup field over here in our projects table will be updated with a higher number. Then that number will get looked up back in our tasks table. Then our formula will recalculate and shift on down. Let's see it live. Here I have no values back. If I check off package, package is now, this changes to one. Package is now brought in here because one equals one. If then we move on to step two gets checked. You see how instantly that formula is recalculating. This is now two, two equals two. So we're now in the shipping. And on the final one, boom, confirmed via email was also completed. And this is now done. This formula right here will only ever have one value. And therefore we can look it up back on our projects table as we've done here to see exactly where this particular project is. I know we went kind of fast in this video. There's a lot to unpack here. So go back and follow it step by step if you struggled at all. Of course, if you got value from this, please consider liking and subscribing to our channel so that we can stay relevant and produce better and better content for you. And in the meantime, keep on building.